Hello everyone and welcome to the Relational Database Model. Developed in 1970 by Dr. E.F. Codd, the Relational Database Model has become the standard used the world over. This is so because it reduces redundancy in the data and allows for data display and manipulation and is therefore more efficient. We will be discussing several topics regarding the Relational Database Model. The first relational database model topic we will discuss is normalization. Normalization reduces redundancy in the data by creating related tables from a separated data structure. This is much easier to store and maintain than unnormalized data. Normalized data table information regards one entity and is stored in one place, quite unlike unnormalized data table information, which could have multiple entities stored in multiple places. Normalization involves the application of something called normal forms. There are 7 of these normal forms, however, data is said to be normalized upon the application of the first 3. The second relational database model topic we will discuss is related tables. One or more tables store the data in cells organized in rows and columns, sometimes called records and fields, respectively. These tables are related to one another, and the means by which they are related is the topic of our next discussion. The third relational database model topic we will discuss is types of relationships. The most common type of relationship is the one-to-many relationship, where the value in each row of a very specific column in one table is the value in many rows of a related column in another table. The data in a one-to-one relationship could typically be stored in one table without significantly impacting storage capacity or database efficiency. It is therefore unpopular. A many-to-many relationship typically requires a linking table with a one-to-many relationship between itself and each of the many-to-many related tables. In this case, using 2 one-to-many relationships is preferred. The fourth relational database model topic we will discuss is constraints. These are enforced rules that restrict the data types that are allowed in either a column or an entire table. This makes databases reliable and accurate because no one can enter invalid data. Common constraints include not null, where the cell must have a value. Default, where a default value is entered instead of a null. Unique, where all values in a column are unique. Primary, where all values in a column are a unique identifier for each row in that table. Foreign, where all values in a column are a unique identifier for each row in another table. Check, where the value's satisfaction of specific conditions is checked. And index, where data can be created and retrieved rapidly. The fifth relational database model topic we will discuss is keys. There are 2 kinds of keys in the relational database model. The first is the primary key, which is data in a column or columns that uniquely identifies each row in a table. When the primary key is more than one column, it is a composite key. A primary key is a requirement for every table in a database, and null values are not allowed. The second kind of key is a foreign key, which is data linked from another table's primary key. It is not required to have the same name as its primary key. This guarantees correspondence between 2 tables. It is not required that foreign keys be unique, and null values are allowed. The sixth relational database model topic we will discuss is indexes. Indexes allow data to be created and retrieved rapidly. Indexes are created automatically for each primary and foreign key. However, any frequently used data can be indexed. The seventh relational database model topic we will discuss is data types. Varying types of information equate to the varying types of data in a column or table. Factors to consider are length and storage. Some common data types include text, numbers, and date and time. Thank you for watching this video. Please see the class exercise on the wiki for practice. Please leave a comment in the comment section below. Thanks, guys.